This next career is a key member of the healthcare team. This professional uses specialized equipment to make ultrasound images of patients so doctors can provide the best care possible. We've got an appointment with a medical sonographer.
Brian?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Lindsay.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome to Kelowna General Hospital.
Thank you.
All right, I'll show you around.
Great.
I'm Lindsay Gullion. I'm a medical sonographer from Kelowna, BC. A medical sonographer is someone that takes a series of diagnostic images. We do write up a preliminary findings report that gets presented to the doctor, and it'll help in the patient's diagnosis. A typical day for us is, you know, getting your patient in the room, getting the machine set up. We make sure our room is sterilized and clean, making sure your equipment is running properly as well. Once you do your examination, go back over to the computer where you write up your case and you look over your images, assess which ones are quality, and then we would write up preliminary findings that will get presented to the doctor along with our images, and then that will help with the diagnosis.
Well, when people think of ultrasound, they immediately think of babies.
Yes.
But it's so much more than that.
It's so much more than babies. Babies are probably a small fraction of what we actually do in a day. We do a lot of abdomen ultrasounds for abdomen pain. Maybe people have gallstones. If someone's had a stroke, sometimes we do carotid ultrasounds. We can do leg ultrasounds looking for blood clots in the veins. In a hospital setting, you do have a variety of shifts. They're typically only 8 hours. And yes, we definitely do overtime. Depending on the day, it could be 20 minutes or it could be 2 hours.
So tell me how closely you're always working with doctors.
Yeah, so when you're a sonographer, especially in a hospital, sometimes we are checking almost every case with them after we're done scanning. Then they want to come in the room sometimes and scan as well. So you definitely work close with them. Typically, you would go to an accredited school and get a diploma, and that can be almost 3 years to 4 years. There are degree options. It doesn't stop there. You do have to become certified and registered. Once you're registered with Sonography of Canada, we have to upkeep our education. That can be anywhere from webinars, or you can go to conferences. There's lots of conferences that are available and online courses that you can take. So every 3 years, you have to have a certain amount of credits to upkeep your registry. There are several ways you can move up. You can start working with students and be a clinical instructor. If you did live somewhere where there is an ultrasound school, you could move into teaching. Also, there's always management if you wanted to move into the management role. So there's definitely different areas you can go into.
And so these are your main tools here, and those would go on top of your patient's skin.
Yeah, so once you get the patient in, you select what transducer you want to use that's appropriate for the exam you're doing. Mm-hmm. Then once you select it and you select your type of study, we would use some ultrasound gel. So I'm just going to put some warm gel on your stomach here. It should be warm. That's actually what gives us our image. So the transducers cannot transmit through air. We need a barrier in between. So if you put one of these on your arm right now, you wouldn't get an image, but if you had some gel on, you would. You definitely have to be good with your hands. You have to learn how to type with your left hand, which everybody always comments on that, because you're scanning typically with your right hand, and then you're typing and measuring with your left hand on the machine. We are dealing with patients all day. People are scared, and some, you know, or maybe they're not getting the best news, or they're going through a hard time. Kind of the first-hand support for these patients a lot of the time. So you definitely need some compassion. Every day is a different day. You are always learning on the job. So I think with the technology that keeps improving, it makes our job improve. My one advice that I would give to somebody that's in the program is don't jump the bullet too soon on taking a job. And I think just taking the time, doing your practicums, learning if you like hospital work or if you like clinic work, because there is a big difference between the two. My favorite part of the job, I think, is when patients come in that are expecting a baby, you do the ultrasound, everything is going great, you bring dad in the room to give them the news, and surprise, it's twins.
Well, thank you so much for showing me around today.
Yeah, no problem. I hope you enjoyed the visit.
I did.
Yeah, and you got to know ultrasound a bit more.
Yeah, it was great.
Perfect, thanks.
Take care. Once again, I'm Brian for Career Trek, reminding you that this career could be yours.